Junoon yane pagalpan, madness. So unless you have that tiny bit of craziness for the arts, you can't imbibe them. So straight away I want to tell you a very nice anecdote. We are talking about rag here in this session. So once my guru, Pandit Firoz Dastur, he was singing at this very big classical music conference. And towards the end of the recital, you know, there's always this part where the audience asks for a request. Farmaish jo kehte hai. So one of those hardcore classical listeners, he got up and says, Meri ek farmaish hai, Pandit ji. Aapka komal rishabh asavari raag. We are not going to let you go until you sing your raag komal rishabh asavari. So my guru just hesitated for a moment, then gave a tongue-in-cheek smile and said, Komal Rishabh Asavari, what do you think I was belting out for the last 40 minutes on this stage? So that was perhaps the last farmaish of his life. So careful where you flash your raag knowledge. But yet, you know, those who recognize raags, we are so envious of them. The lay listener is extremely enamored. Ah, he recognizes raags. Raag pehchan leta hai. So I am here to say today, it's not a very difficult thing, provided you have a fairly good musical ear, some guided music listening, and passion for music. We are going to try this experiment here today and see whether we can recognize raags. Because you know, when you go to a recital and you have this classical music freak sitting next to you, sometimes humming along with the performer on stage, and he sees you looking lost and says, Raag Pahadi chal raha hai. That's Raag Pahadi going on, and you say, oh yeah, I thought so. So let's go ahead and say that once the raag bug has bitten you, once the raag bug has bitten you, you will start finding raag anywhere, in any kind of music, in any song. Are you ready to give me a listening for raags in unexpected places? Ashish ready? We have Ashish Biswas with us today, who is joining us in this madness, in this junoon. Okay, here goes. Alap in raag Mishra Bhairavi. Sarigama mapadhava mapamagama dhamaga gare sa. Okay, raag mishra bhai. Sarigama pagama re sa. Dadang dadang. Oh, chori chori kiya re. Haan, dil hi dil diya re. Haan, chori chori kiya re. दिल ये दिल दिया रे जादू से जादू किया किया रे ओ जागी सोई रहूं खोई खोई रहूं उसकी यादों में उसके आंखों में झूमे जिया रे क्रेजी किया रे भैरवी दिस इज नथिंग बट भैरवी धूम टू धूम मचाले धूम मिश्र भैरवी And this is how a thumri would sound in Mishra Bhairavi. Aa purab mat jaiyo more raja ji purab mat jaiyo more raja ji purab mat jaiyo purab mat jaiyo purab mat jaiyo purab mat jaiyo more raja ji That was Mishra Bhairavi. Madmat Sarang. Ne sare mare, pa mare ni re sa. Ni ne sa sa sare re sa. sa sa ni sa re sa re ma re ma pa ni ma ma re sa ni re sa. Ho ho munni badnaam hui darling tere liye, munni badnaam hui darling tere liye, munni ke gaal gulabi nain sharabi chaal nawabi re aaj handu baam hui darling. मदमात सारंग रे रे सम मरे बब मनी नि नि बम रे सनि रे सा ने सारे मा बनी नि बम रे मम रे सनि रे सा छैया 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 जल छैया जय मदमात सारंग छैया 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 चल छैया छैया जय. वो यार है जो खुशबू की तरह, वो जिसकी जुबान उर्दू की तरह, मेरी शाम रात मेरी कायनात, ओ यार मेरा सैया सैया जैया जैया जय. दे यू गो मदमात सारंग. हो जग घूमे आ थार जैसा न कोई, जग घूमे आ थार जैसा न कोई. यू ऑल नो द वर्ड्स टू दिस.
नव सजरी जवानी कहीं, नव अखी अनुरानी कहीं, हो जग घूमे आ थार जैसा
What about Western music? Rags in Western.
Every night in my dreams I see you, I feel you. That is how I know you go.
Mishra Tilak ka mod.
गारे ने ने सा
भीमपलास
ने सा मा गारे ने सा ओनली विमर ओनली विमर ओनली विमर विमर हाँ तुतुरु 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 नेस कैफे.
Another one.
Da 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 da.
Impalas. Yeah. All these are, of course, not the pure rag, but I would say jhalaks of the rag, notes of the rag.
Gare ni sa ma ma gare.
All bimpalas.
I'm in love with the shape of you, push and pull like a magnet do, although my heart is falling too. I'm in love with your body, oh, 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 oh.
Very much. Actually, bimpalas or rag dhani.
Sa ga ma pa ni pa ma ga ma ga ni ga sa.
Coming to jazz. Rags in jazz too.
Summertime and the living is easy. Fish are jumping and the cotton is high. Sa ga ma da ni sa ni ni sa dha.
Raga ma ga ma dha ma dha ni dha ni sa. Rag Malkans, Summertime.
Koyaliyan bole ambuwa ki dar par, koyaliyan bole ambuwa ki dar par, re tu basant ki det sandeshwa, nayo kaliyan par gunjat bhavra, unke sang karat rang raliya, koyaliyan bole ambuwa.
Malkans. Bhagyashree.
I once had a girl, or should I say, she once had me. Sa sa ga ma dha ni sa ma ga re sa ni dha ni dha ma ga ma ga re sa. She showed me her room, isn't it good, Norwegian good.
There we go, rags in Western music. What about Western classical? Dararang 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 dararang. Mozart's 40th. Dararang 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 dararang.
Itna na mujhse tu pyar badha ki main.
You all know that song of Salil Chaudhary. Bass. But it's actually again a Mishra Bhairavi. So basically, once you get the magic of the rag, you'll start detecting it in absolutely any tune you hear, in the whirring of a fan, in the reverse horn of a car also. The question is, what is rag? What is rag? So suppose we were to open the dictionary and one day you decide, I'm going to, you know, understand what rag is. So you open the musical dictionary to find out the meaning. And maybe we can have the first slide now, Ishan. A melodic scheme characterized by a definite scale of notes, order of sequence of these notes, melodic phrases, pauses, stasis, and tonal graces, and which produce an aesthetic emotion. I gather you didn't understand much. So we are here to ask you to define rag. Strangely, in the Sanskrit text, a very simple and easy definition of rag. Ranjayati iti ragaha. That which pleases is a rag. Lovely. But still, a lot has to be said about rag. I prefer the Sanskrit definition though, if we were to choose. So let's try and define rag. Let's try and define it. Anyway, I wanted to ask you that those of you over here who can recognize basic rags, are there any people here? I know some of my students do recognize rags. Anybody else amongst the audience who can recognize basic rags? Good, that's nice. Well, I've been thinking that how do people come to recognize rags? Number one, if you're a student of music yourself, you're learning an instrument or you're learning vocal, so then obviously you pick up rags along the way. The other thing is, you're born in a family who has been playing classical music around you. So consciously or unconsciously, you start imbibing it. These are the two main ways in which you learn rags. What is the third option for the layman? What do you think is... How does a layman? Yeah? programs like yeah, short 1.5 hours. But I think the third way is maintaining a little notebook and maybe having a friend who knows music and trying to start listing out film songs based on rags or, you know, like jingles, patriotic songs. Get someone and note them down in your little book. Then if you go to a concert, you'll hear that and you'll be able to slowly associate. We're going to try that here. We're going to try that. I'm going to hum 3 lines for you from old Hindi music. And then ask you a question at the end. Sorry. Okay. I'm humming 3 lines for you, singing 3 lines, and then asking you the question.
Aansu bhari hai nigaahein milane ko kahin ye wo to nahi dheere se tera ye muskaana.
That's it. Now I'm going to ask you, what was common to these? What was common? Yes, I'm looking for a nice word.
Da 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 da.
What do you think? Yeah, same notes. That is a correct, but too technical. I want an even simpler word. Sadness is the mood. Sadness is the mood. But what is common? Huh? Yeah, that is also common. I'm looking for a word beginning with T. A simple tune. Tune, that's it. So I think next slide we can have now. I want to define rag first. Level 1, a rag is a recognizable tune. Agreed? Rag is a recognizable tune. So even in today's songs, here I took the very classic Bollywood songs, but even if I take today's
pal 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 har pal har pal kaise bitega pal har pal har pal sandeshe aate hain hame tadpate hain savariya ha 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 savariya.
Got it? I mean, they all have a similar tune, simple, they are based on the same rag. So first level of definition of rag is, a rag is a recognizable tune. And now I think we can go to our exercises, because now your work begins. Those exercises have been handed out. Can we put the exercise number 1 on? Yeah, so we'll start. Okay. What basically I'm trying to do is to get your ears attuned to recognizing rags and recognizing tunes. Yeah, okay, so I'm going to sing your options. Exercise 1, can I sing out the options for you?
Oh, Sajna, Barkha Baharai, Ras Ki Puhanai, Akhiyon Mein Pyar Lai, Oh Sajna.
That's the first option. Second option.
Madhuban Mein Radhika Naache Re Gire, Ghar Ki Murali Aavaje Re. Madhuban Mein Radhika Naache.
Okay. Third option.
Jaane Kahan गए वो दिन कहते थे तेरी राह में नजरों को हम बिछाएंगे चाहे कहीं भी तुम.
Okay, and so on. These are your options. Now I will sing a song and you have to find out which song from this option matches the tune. Ready? So I want the lay people to take more of an effort before the rag recognizers raise their hands. Okay, so now here's my song.
Lage na mora jiya,
सजना नहीं या भारती जाने कहाँ सुपर आई हैव अनदर सॉन्ग फॉर मेरे By the way, you can start your little notebook right now. This is Raag Shivranjani. So, Bharti, are you adept at recognizing Raags or is this the first time you've been able to? Okay, but you could easily identify the two tunes. Good, thank you. I think a lot of you recognize this. How many of you got it right? Quite a few. Was it? Yeah. Shivranjani, Raag Shivranjani. We are already on exercise 2. Exercise 2, identifying matching film songs from the new Hindi film songs. See, the thing was, I knew I would have a mixed audience, those who would be knowing the old Bollywood numbers, but there would be some of the youth who wouldn't know some of them. So I had to take some of the newer songs too. Okay, so exercise 2 is the same thing. Kajra re, tere kare kare naina. Kajra. Sorry, it's a little low. Kare kare naina, mere naina, tere naina, tere naina jud. You all know this song. Chain ven sab loota. Okay, that's option 1. Second. Jhalak dikhla ja. झलक दिखला जा एक बार आ जा 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 झलक दिखला जा यू ऑल नो दिस झलक दिखला जा एक बार आ जा 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 ओके थर्ड ऑप्शन नहीं 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 ये बात है पुरानी कैसी पहेली है ये कैसी पहेली जिंदगानी हाँ रोका इसको किसने ये तो बहता पानी कैसी पहेली है ये कैसी पहेली जिंदगानी ओके सो नाउ माय सॉन्ग्स विल स्टार्ट फाइंड आउट द वन दैट मैचेस आशिक बनाया आशिक बनाया अपने तेरे बिन जूं तलक दिख सुपर फास्ट राग रिकग्निशन फैंटास्टिक दैट रो ओवर देयर इज फैंटास्टिक द बैक रो इज मोर सॉन्ग सो व्हाट राग इज दिस दिस इज राग भीम पलास अगेन इश्क जैसी है एक आंधी सेम राग तू चीज बड़ी है मस्त मस्त तू चीज बड़ी है मस्त झलक दिखला जा सो नाउ द आइडिया इज व्हेन यू गो टू अ कॉन्सर्ट नाउ एंड यू हियर द सिंगर डिंग यू से ओ इट साउंड लाइक आशिक बनाया एंड देन यू लुक एट योर नेबर एंड से राग भीम पलास चल दैट इज व्हाट यू एक्सरसाइज नंबर थ्री ओके नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू सिंग नॉट अ फिल्म सॉन्ग आई एम गोइंग टू सिंग अ क्लासिकल कॉम्पोजिशन एंड यू विल हैव दीज थ्री ऑप्शंस The options are Man tadpat hari darshan ko aaj Man tadpat hari darshan ko aaj Mohe tum bin bikre sagre kaaj सेकेंड ऑप्शन ना बोले रे घूंघट के पट ना खोले रे राधा last. Poochho na kaise maine rehne bitaye, poochho na kaise maine rehne bitaye, ek pal jaise ek jug bita, ek pal jaise ek jug bita, jug bi Okay, these are your options. Now, here starts my classical singing. Mukh mod mod musgaat jaab mukh. I have the pleasure of singing. Musgaat jaat at chabili naar kar kar singaar mukh mod mod musgaat. Yeah, rag malkos. Yeah. Okay, exercise four, right? Exercise four. Again, guessing from a classical bandish. I will sing a classical bandish or composition. Your options are
बदतमीज दिल बदतमीज दिल माने ना ये जो हाल है ना 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 सवाल है जाने ना बदतमीज दिल बद
I just can't get myself to memorize words of new Hindi film songs so there'll be a lot of tararara along the way so
मोरा पिया मोसे बोलते नहीं मोरा पिया मोसे बोलते द्वार जिया के खोलत नहीं मोरा पिया मुझसे बोलत नहीं
एंड लास्ट सॉन्ग
ओ बुल्ला के जाना मैं कौन बुल्ला के जाना मैं कौन बुल्ला के जाना
Okay, now here begins my classical.
Nen so nen milaye ke rakho ji din din dage tak. Nen so nen milaye ke rakho ji nen so nen milaye ke rakho manwa
Come on, I want to hear. Huh? Mora Pia, correct. Anything else? All are the same. All are. So I was hoping this one. trick question. All. I think somebody over here had got really puzzled that either she's made a mistake in her exercise. Perfect. So we have one person who got it. All are in Rag Darbari Kannada. Rag Darbari Kannada. Okay, exercise number 5 is guessing from alap. Guessing from alap. Okay, your options.
Sare gam pa gam re mohe bhul gaye savariya. आवन कह गए अज हुन आए आवन कह गए अज हुन आए लीनी न मोरी खबरी आए मोहे भूल गए सावरिया भूल गए
That's one. Second.
हमको मन की शक्ति
And third, options. And now I'll take some alap. So no more songs, alap, and you'll guess from the alap which song. Yes, which one is that? Mohe Bhul. Who said Mohe Bhul? Correct. Yes, correct. Well, even before I did two alaps, you've already guessed. So I think this for me is the way of getting close to rag. Because if we were to take the newer, younger generation, all they know is the songs that they have around them. Bollywood mainly, Hindi movie songs. That is the song they're listening to, or then Western rock and pop. So through association of tune is the key word, is the way to getting close to rag. I haven't yet found any other way. Either you learn, be a student of music yourself, but the lay listener doesn't want to be a student of music. He or she just wants to be able to get deeply into it. I think this is the path. And we come finally to exercise number 6, where we move away from film songs and get to patriotic songs. And this time, I don't want you to tell me the name of the option song. Just yell out the rag name when you recognize. Okay? Your options, of course, you all know. Mile sur mera tumhara to sur bane hamara. Okay, this is the first one. Vaishnav jan to tene kahiye je peed parai jaane re. Now this I'm just singing out the options first. Vande mataram, vande mataram, sujala Jashitala. Okay, these are your three options. Now I'll start. I'll take some alap. It could be either of these three songs. Don't tell me the song. Just scream out the rag name. I'm not making it very easy and singing exactly like the song. Yeah, Kamaj. That was Kamaj. Now the elimination gets easier because there are less options. Kaun sa raag hai? Raag Des. Superb. Now by option, by default. There you are. You recognize rags, and I'm happy. I thought I'd like to go back to that, what are the characteristics of rag? Can we go back to that slide? We are already on the second level. A rag is a recognizable tune. What else? Now we prove the, we've already proved line one, second line. A rag has a fixed set of notes. You have to adhere only to those notes. So your question will be why? Correct? Why don't we have the freedom to roam around, touch some other notes along the way? Again, I don't want to give you that answer. I want to sing a little bit of a rag for you. A rag with five notes. Sa ga pa dha ni sa, sa ni dha pa ga sa. Here it is, rag, five notes. This rag is called Kalavati. If you want to know film songs that match Kalavati, I can tell you a few film songs. Kae tar sa, you know that song? Jiyara, from the old, from the new repertoire. Ye tara wo tara har tara, ye tara wo tara. Okay, so now I'm going to sing rag Kalavati for a short time. The beginning I'll be taking some alaps. The moment you feel some other notes have been touched which weren't supposed to, just put your hand up. I want to see the lay listener catch notes that weren't supposed to be in the rag. Hopefully you'll do it in the correct place and not embarrass me. Everything seemed to just collapse. So sometimes one person in the audience once told me, ma'am, you went besura. I didn't go besura. I touched other notes. And even the most lay listener felt, oh, something went wrong here, right? So what do you think the fixed set of notes is for? Why fixed? What would you say? Why do we keep to that? Yeah, it's sort of built up a certain mood. So it goes on in that mood. If you suddenly hit something else, it's almost as if that entire thing you were building fell flat to the ground. And that is why, however, in Western music, they move from chord to chord very dexterously, and that is properly planned, not from anywhere to anywhere. But in Western, they have chordal progression of music. So it sounds very natural. Here in this melodic system of music, you can't start suddenly going to another chord or touching other notes. You have to say. Once actually somebody told me in the audience when I played this game, they said, ma'am, that sounded like Western music, what I did. So, okay, so do you agree with me? Now, second level of definition. A rag has a fixed set of notes. Third level, a rag has a fixed ascent and descent. That means it has a way of going up and coming down. sometimes very simple, straight up and straight down. Nirega madhani sani da pamagare sa. Straight. Nirega madhani sani da pamagare sa. Ragyaman. A very straight ascent and descent. Sometimes it's zigzag. Sa ma ga pa ma pa dha ni sa da pa dha ma sa re. See this way of going up and down, curving. Sa dha ma pa dha pa ga re. Again, a very zigzag movement. So some rags have a different way of going up. The favorite Malhar rag. Again, very zigzag. Sa ma re pa ma pa ni da ni sa. And coming down. Sa ni pa ga ma re sa. Vakra rag we say. Vakra chalan. To rag ka chalan or movement. It has a certain movement. And finally, which comes to the title of our show. A rag is appealing. It gives aesthetic pleasure. So now I want to address the mathematicians in the crowd. Anyone who's scientific, maths, you too? Wow. The creative and the technical is all here. Okay, so I want to ask her. We have about 12 notes in the Indian scale. 7 notes, and with the sharps and flats, that makes it 12 notes. Okay? For a rag to happen, you need 5 notes minimum. So, if you were to do permutation combination, 12 notes, out of that, 5 has to be basic to make a rag. How many can you get options? I mean, if you were to make permutation combination.
7 to 6. 7 multiplied
by 6.
7 is
2. So, because I'm saying a number that can almost not be defined, you can have any kind of combinations and call them rags. Oh, only, is it? I thought that. Anyway, people often ask how many rags are there. I don't think anyone has a correct answer. Yeah, I mean 5. You can have 7, you can have 6. You can have 6 in the ascent, 5 in the descent, 5 in the ascent, 6 in the... You know what I mean? You can have all kinds. So you can have just countless number of, but in existence, how many rags are there? 100, 150? Huh?
144.
Oh, someone has a perfect number. I couldn't find it on Google also. Yeah, so roughly that number. And out of that, how many are really sung? Fabulous. Thank you for, you've taken charge of this part because somewhere or the other. No, I'm saying commonly played maybe 77. So anyway, so why is that? Because all the combinations are not arresting. The notes were, for example, I was trying to make a combination, very difficult to make some, which doesn't make any sense. Let me find that. Like if you do something like, sa re re ma pa ni sa, bad sounding, clumsy sounding, or sa re ga ma dha sa, something which doesn't sound aesthetically right. Let me try again. That sounded quite good actually. Sa re ga ma dha sa, not really creating any mood or not sounding good together. This was the toughest exercise in the whole workshop that I was preparing. Trying to fit together notes that don't make aesthetic sense. So, where are we? Yeah, a rag is appealing. Only the notes that create a certain mood, a certain nice feeling, get qualified as rags. And therefore, you know, a lot of contemporary musicians also create rags. You know that, right? I mean, there are ancient rags and there are people who devise their own rags or create rags. Sometimes they don't have a very much of a life because the best combinations have already been exploited earlier. And okay, here's an easy thing for the lay listeners. A rag has pakads. A pakad is a catchphrase. So you don't need to know, for example, you want to learn rag, you don't need to know all the notes. If you know the pakad, you can guess. So let me show you old film pakads. I showed you one. Ni re re ga, aasu bhari hai, ni ga hai. The moment the singer on the stage does, yaman hai. That's all. He doesn't have to sing more of the notes at all. Here's yaman for you. Here's the pakad of yaman. Again, the pakad of another rag. Pa pa ga ma dha. This is hamir. Madhuban me radhika na. Yeah. All you know is this. The singer does hamir. So your book is handy, right over there. Madhuban me radhika, pakad of rag hamir. Another pakad from old film song. Ga madha pare sa ga ga ma. Anyone know this song? Tu jahan jahan chale. Ragnand. That's Ragnand. That's all the performer has to do. Nand. You don't need anything more. Immediately. That's the character of the rag. Another one. Anyone know that rag? Fantastic. That's all she had to hear. Didn't it? Sa ma ga pa humko man ke sha. Rag Kedar. And then pa pa ni da ni sa. Ni dha ni sa, bol re pa pi. Yeah. So ni dha ni sa, rag niya ki malar. Yeah. Now what about the contemporary Bollywood listeners? Sa pa ma pa ga ma re sa. Pakad of rag Bhairavi. Which is the song? Dhoom Machale. Sare ni sare mare ni ni sa. Munni. Madmat sarang. Mare ni sare mare ni sa. Pakad of rag madmat sarang. Munni badna. Absolutely and purely rag madmat sarang. Okay. Ga pa pa dha ni dha pa dha pa ga. Ga pa dha ni dha. Ye tara wo tara har tara. Rag Kalavati. That's the pakad. Okay, another one from contemporary. Sa ga ma sa ga sa. What rag is this? Ga ma sa ga sa. Dil se re dil se. Rag Jog. Rag Jog. Sagare magar re pa magar. Rag Gaur Sarang. This is the pakad. Dil hai chota sa choti si aasha. Ni sagare magar pare sa. Gaur Sarang. So that's it, guys. That sums up rag completely for you. I hope you understand rag, what rag is. This is what rag is. And actually at the end of this, rag becomes like a person, you know. Like, hi Yaman, I know you. I know how you go up, I know how you come down. I know what the notes you don't like. I know your likes and dislikes. I know what's your crux, the pakad. So it's literally like you handshake a rag and says, I know you. You know, you're my pal. And that's what we are aiming for, that you understand these rags almost like personalities, you know, I know you. Yeah. I mean, we could have some questions here before I go on ahead. Though Edgar, I admit I have not been keeping a track of the time. We still have time to go on with moods in rags. We have, right? Yeah, good. You know, moods is something which is very subjective, of course. But we have such beautiful dimensions in Indian classical music. We have seasonal rags, we have times of the day, we have happy, sad, whatever, moods. Trying to get to know it a little better. Once I was commissioned to do a workshop for a group of French students. Young French students who were passing through Mumbai, and they said, do a workshop for them. So I said, maybe I should do something interactive. They've never even heard any Indian music sounds. Let me try and make it interactive. So I sang this for them. And I said, guess the mood of these notes. Sa re ga pa ni sa ga re ni pa ga re ga sa. Sa re ga pa ga pa ni sa. Sa ni ba ba ga re sa. I had a smile on my face. Re re sa ga ga re pa ba ga ni ni ba sa ni ba ba ga re sa. La gi la ga na sa ki pa ti sa ne. La gi la ga na sa ki pa ti sa ne. Parama sukha. Ati anandan lagi lagana sakhi pati sa lagi lagana sakhi pati sa lagi lagana sakhi. So this is what I sang, and then I asked those French teenagers, what was the mood? Stone silence, no reply. After some time, a timid boy put up his hand. So I said, yes, that was very sad. I said, I'm right at the start of my workshop. The first mood itself has completely flopped. How do I go ahead? So I had to quickly think. So I said, okay, if you found that sad, sa re ga. Sa re ga ma da ma ga re ma ga re ga re. Now then they understood what is sad for us. But then looking back, I'm saying, you know, for them it's, first of all, it's vocal music. It sounds they are completely not familiar with words. It was too much of an input right at the beginning for them to really perceive a mood. They've not grown up in this part of the world. So these sounds are new to them. But Indian music in general, the whole mood is kind of introspective, contemplative, somber. So that is probably what he meant, that this doesn't sound like a, you know, very, this sounds like something serious going on here. And that may have been their reaction. So just some simple rules about, simple rules for mood. When you have the natural scale, sa re ga pa dha sa, this is happy. This is the major scale of Western music. This is our natural or shuddha, what we call shuddha notes. Sa re ga pa dha sa sounds happy. Sa dha pa ga re sa. Suppose we change one note there to a flat, see what happens. Sa re ga pa dha sa, sa dha pa ga re. Immediate change. Just one note is changed there. The ga has become into a flat ga. Mood change. This is quite universal. In Western, they have the minor scale with a few, you know, some Western music students here. Anyway, I'm just being careful if I say something. I always check. So, yeah. Moment you get those kind of softer, what we call komal notes, change of mood from happy to sad. So if you sa re ga pa dha sa, sayonara, vaada nibhaungi sayonara, balkati aur itlaati, kal phir aaungi sayonara, 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 very happy. But Sare ga pa da sa jaane kahan. One note difference. Gaye wo dil. Yeah? Immediately sad. So flat notes give a sadder tone and the major scale or the shuddha notes happier. Now what about that slide on Ishan, is there? Oh, your Ishan, sorry. So slide on the nine rasas. You've heard this word rasas in ras in Indian music. There was a Bharat Muni, a sage called Bharat Muni, somewhere between 2 BC to 4 AD. And he had written a treatise, whatever, on dramaturgy. And he had got, have all the rasas come there? Okay, eight rasas actually. Shringar or love, Hasya, humorous, Karuna, pathos, Raudra, furious, Veer, valorous, Bhayanka, fearful, Bibhatsa, odious, Adbhut, wondrous, Shant. Shant ras was added much later. Bharat had only identified eight rasas or moods, you can call them. But music doesn't use all these. Indian music, I mean drama may have all of these. Indian music has probably three or four only. Shringar, Yaman. I mean, I'll give you examples of Shringar or love is there. Veera is there, or the valorous heroic. Karuna is there, pathos. Shantaras is there, peaceful. Others are not really used in our classical music. They are all for drama and maybe other arts. So Shringar. Nire mare gare sa ragyaman. So you have the most romantic songs coming out of there. Naam gum jayega, chehra ye badal jayega, meri aawaz hi pehchaan hai. So many other. Gar yaad rahe. And the evergreen favorite. Let me find that for you. Aaj jaane ki zid na karo. All these.
Yun hi pehlu mein baithe raho. Aaj jaane ki zid na karo.
All these are Yaman. Do you feel, without explanation, you are born in India, do you feel the love in that? Okay, so Yaman is one of the examples. Veeraras, or the valorous, take a rag like rag Durga. Sare ma pa dha ma re re pa ma pa dha da sa re sa dha ma pa dha ma dha ra sa. This is heroic. Mata bhavani kali mata bhavani, kali mata bhavani, kali mata bhavani. So this rag is supposed to
Durga Gauri Vighan Harini Sugadari.
So this, you know, description of the goddess Durga and the rag together gives this valorous effect. And then of course Karuna, pathos.
Sare ga ma dha ma ga re sa.
Definitely pathos.
Ga ma dha ni dha madhani sa re ga re sa ni sa dha ma dha ma ga re sa. Ab more naiya paar karo, ab more naiya paar karo, oh
So these are, I would say, the three dominant modes. But then you may have something like a detachment. Sa ni sa re sa, sa re ma pa ni pa ma re ni sa re. Have you heard our mantras? You know, the Vedic mantras and chanting. Re sa ni sa re, pa ni sa re ni re sa. Gives you a feeling of detachment. So we have virakti karas, virakti. They may not be mentioned here. Or separation. Pa ma da pa ga ma re ga. Rag Puriya Dhanashree. You feel the separation. Ga ma dha ni re ni dha pa ma da pa ga ma re ga. Viraharas, which comes under Shringaras. Okay. So that's my very brief, I would say brief presentation on ras. But ras has a deeper meaning which I'll get to later. Any questions on mood? Notice we don't have a happy mood at all. There's comic, but we don't use that in Indian music. Happy kidhar hai? We are too serious a race. And the moods are not obvious either. Very suggestive, more contemplative, more meditative our music. You may not feel the ras very distinctly. I just hope I'm not going beyond the time, but I want to tell them, not at all, good. Because I also wanted to cover the time relationship. You all know about rags for morning, rags for evening, rags for midnight. So what is this? Is this something that has been taught to us and we are just adhering to it? Is there something really inherent in the rag? What do you feel? Any thoughts? Actually, this theory has not been postulated as such, but it has stood the most stringent test, that of time. Till today, all of us who are into Hindustani music are adhering. We feel that rag at that time of the day. Nobody is really trying to break the rules and sing a Yaman in the morning or a Todi at night. The belief is that the sages who meditated upon the notes, they were really in tune with nature, the ones who created the rags. And they felt that a certain combination vibe with the body rhythm at a certain time of the day. And that is why, just like, let's take our food pattern. It's quite common all over the world. You get up, there's some hot drink, then you have a kind of a breakfast, then there's a gap, then you have a lunch, then you have tea. These are all bodily needs. I mean, how have these food and drink patterns? You don't wake up and want to eat naan and palak paneer. So in the same way, I think certain notes are easily digestible at that time of day. And therefore let me show you, for example, if we want to show dawn. Dawn is not, we are not trying to paint the sun rising or the rays coming or the birds chirping. That's not what the effort is. The effort is, how is your heart and body feeling at that time of day? That is the time connection. Sa re ga ma re re sa ga ma dha dha. Dha ma pa ga ma re. This is dawn. Do you feel it?
Jago jiyara chhaye, man ka andhera jaye. Jago re mere man mohan pyare.
Know that song from Jagte Raho? The notes make you feel the morning. or the tune you used to hear in the 90s. Sa da da ma ma pa dha pa ga re sa. That's dawn. Sa da, maybe the sweep of the sun. Sa da ma da sa dha ni re. Ma pa da ma pa ga pa ga re sa. That's Raag Bhatiyal. Purab se surya uga phaila ujiyar. You know, all know, remember this tune? Jaagi har disha disha jaga jag sara purab se surya uga. That's dawn. Whereas if you were to listen to a western composition representing morning, you would find the composer has put in parts for the instrument to show the sun, parts to show the birds chirping, parts to show the wind. So that's a very different way of evoking the morning mood. Different in Indian music. You've got to find it in the notes. You've got to find it within your body. No painting or picture for you. Nothing spelt out, no landscape drawn. That is how subtle it is. Similarly, if you were to take midnight, dhane sa, see the notes are only heavy. Sa re ga ma re sa ni sa re sa dha. These heavy notes. Sa re ga ma pa ga ma re sa. This is midnight. Or ga ma ga sa dha ne ne sa. Sa ga ma 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 ga. This is the heaviness of midnight. Raag Malkaon's Raag Darbari Kanra. Yes, Edgar, I can see you getting shifty there. We are almost done. The final seasonal connection. Seasonal connection. Yeah?
I really wanted to ask you.
Good, good. Yeah, the season. Now, if you were to hear Vivaldi's Spring. Ta 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 da 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 ta ra da ta ta da 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 ta ra da ta ra ta 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 ra ra ta ra ta ta ra ra ta ra ta ta ra ra na 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 na. That's really spring, isn't it? Ta ta ta. You absolutely feel the buds opening and no, and in that they do have the chirping of the birds played by certain instruments. Indian music. You will not find it. just see what our basant sounds like.
Bagiyan phulwariyali ritu basant ayo sakhi bol rahi koyali asara sara.
Rather sad, isn't it? Sani dhani dhani dhava madhava maga magare sani rega madhani sara sara. Sad tune for spring. That's because, again, to give an explanation, the feeling is that after a die-hard winter of the north, when spring first comes, tears of joy well up. This is our way of looking at happiness. This is a Hindu philosophy. Suffer, work, next life will be happy. So, these are the kind of moods. For example, the rains. Mare pa, the joy when after scorching summer, rain first comes. So no pitter patter of raindrops, dark clouds. Mare pa, leap of joy. Paga mare, downward rain. Mare pa, mani pa, paga mare. And they say that Tansen was wandering in the woods. Tansen, who created the raga, and he heard the creatures of the wood making sounds of two close frequencies. Na 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 na. And he used that. Ne 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 sa sa ni baga mare. Very subtle, very suggestive. So kind of, I'm towards the conclusion, ras, as I told you, which we translated as mood, but it's something more, and I want to read it. Ras, which literally means juice, essence or taste, connotes a concept in the Indian arts about the aesthetic flavor of any visual, literary or musical work that evokes an emotion or feeling in the reader or audience that cannot be described. That is ras, getting the ras and becoming a rasika. To put it simply, when an artist and a listener together reach out for a moment of joy, shared joy, that moment is ras. Then you felt the ras of the rag. Thank you. So I'm concluding, Edgar. I'm concluding with a very nice, very kind of egoistic for Indians, but a very nice quotation, not written by an Indian, but a British historian. I can close that now. The vast literature, okay, I'll say who's written it, it's Arnold Toynbee, a British historian, has said this. The vast literature, the magnificent opulence, the majestic sciences, the soul-touching music, the awe-inspiring gods, it is already becoming clearer that a chapter which has a Western beginning will have to have an Indian ending if it is not to end in the self-destruction of the human race. At this supremely dangerous moment in history, the only way of salvation for mankind is the Indian way. Thank you for being with me and guessing rags and reaching out for shared moments of joy. Thank you. Thank you, Junoon. Thank you, Ashish. Lovely.
Do we have any questions?
Yeah.
I have a question.
Yes, I do.
Please go ahead.
No, she was asking, when am I performing next, which is not a good question for any artist.
This mood that you were saying, I was also wondering whether sometimes the same rag that is supposed to be, you know, Shringar and all that can also sound sad.
Absolutely. I had a section on that.
So, question is it sometimes to do with the instrument or the voice, like anything in sitar will sound happy and anything on a sarangi will sound
sad? I'll tell
sad.
You what the mood depends on. I've got my notes here. Mood depends on so many things. The speed at which you're singing, the tempo, the words. All these things can affect something. You might say this rag is very grave, but I'll show you.
मुख मोड़ मोड़ मुस्कात जान मुख मोड़ मोड़ मुस्कात
Now this might give you a very peaceful. Medium tempo I'm singing, but suppose Durge Bhavani, Durge Bhavani, same rag, but I'm singing at a higher pitch. The shantaras has gone and a very excitable mood has ensued. So tempo, whether you're singing high or low, what are the words being used, all that affects the mood. So you can't really say ras or mood is in the rag. There are extraneous factors depending. Yeah, any more questions?
So I wanted to ask you, Dhanashree ji, is firstly thank you so much for coming and being with us in this Mumbai Local. Thank you so much. I wanted to ask you is roughly how long has it been that you've been an acclaimed Hindi singer and what are the consequences and how much does it affect your throat on a daily basis?
Affects throat on a daily basis, yes. Because talking about the weather changes here, I'm feeling even the lay person is complaining, you know, of throat problems. So yes, there's a kind of a regimen which singers, I think, are sticking to, not having the cold stuff and, you know, rest, periodical rest, the early morning practice which helps your, you know, voice. Is that answering your question, kind of? Yes, you have to take care. You do have to take care of your voice. You do have to take care. You know, sometimes we are not much of good company. I won't go to a pub, for example, because I have to talk at the top of my voice to communicate. So I would not go to any pub kind of place before a music concert, for example, where my voice would get strained just talking to the person in front of me. Yes, there is voice care to be taken.
Discipline. Have
yeah. Yeah, it's a discipline.
It is a discipline.
Yeah. We are not good people to hang out with.
Madam, this time theory is nowadays not much believed, right? Because nowadays any rag is sung at any time.
Not so much in the North Indian system, artists are still adhering to time. I'll tell you where the change has come. Sometimes people have made jod rags, where they have, you know, joined together a morning rag and a night rag. Then where do you place it? So that rag is kind of has no time. Or people are saying that when you're in an auditorium, where do you know whether it's dawn or dusk? Or, you know, so there are some arguments for the time theory. Karnatak music does not adhere to time. They sing any rag any time. So these are some of the arguments about the time theory. But by and large, all Hindustani classical music artists just enjoy. They're not doing it because it's a rule. Because they don't feel the rag at the time which is not supposed to be at.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Western music has choral tunes.
Yeah, it does have. It does have. It does have sharps and flats. So they call it flat. We call it komal swar. They also have that. Yes.
Hmm. Madam, how is the theory of application of Hindustani music to illnesses?
Well,
there
you
are
a
lot of articles.
Yes.
Based, if you have a cardiac problem, then this rag is suitable.
As you know, it's not a very tangible theory, but somebody is trying something, you know, based on this very similar principle, flats and sharps, and how much it is really, you'll have to try out yourself. But yes, there are a few musicians who have taken it upon them to see whether there's something for cough. And something for, you know, the various
cardiac
ailments.
I've heard for cardiac.
But, you know, I'll tell you one thing. For example, my son, when he's concentrating on studies, he puts on Indian instrumental music. Though he's more of a Western music musician and a Western music listener. When he's doing any concentrated work, I can hear from his room that he's listening to Indian instrumental. So that Indian music has a way of getting inside you. I had a colleague with whom I was doing Indo-Western musical workshops. He had very strong views. He would say, if you want to listen to Indian classical music, hear it at night. Because it's that music that helps you come close to yourself. But if you're listening to Western classical, hear it during the day. because it's that kind of music that's telling you, go out there, you know, grab the day kind of theory. Yes, absolutely, absolutely.
I have a question.
Yeah, sure.
There's this new trend, I wouldn't say trend, but this new sort of music coming out in Western music called atonal music. Right?
Yes.
So how does that fit with Raga as well?
That would be the rag we said, no, that doesn't measure up. Oh. Well, I haven't heard enough of it to make a... But people are enjoying it.
So will that be a rag that displeases and then still pleases after all?
You'll have to, because it's so subjective. If you get something out of it, then it's making sense. But let me listen to more of that before I comment on atonal music, yeah.
Madam, this Tivra Ma is what type of a note?
Yeah, Tivra Ma is a very interesting note. Okay. They say the Tivra Ma is used a lot for rags that are in between night and day. Like, for example, the sunset, or what we call twilight, Tivra Ma. Similarly, early morning, when day and night is somewhere in between, Tivra Ma is used. That has been the theory, because there was one musicologist called Pandit Vishnu Bhatkhande,
yeah,
who has written a whole theory, yeah, of music, because, yeah, earlier Indian music was not written down, not, you know, notated. So, yeah, one of them took it upon themselves, one of the pandits, and, yeah, said, no, we have to document all this.
Yeah.
So he made a theory actually that rags which have their main note in the first tetrachord, they are night rags. Rags which have their main note in the second tetrachord, they are morning, yeah, rags. So he made quite a,
yeah,
good argument, you know, for argument's sake, he made a good theory on time. And he said, Madha pa ma, this rag ma ga ma re ga, where night and morning,
yeah,
are meeting. Yeah. Similar, in the morning you have rag lalat. Ma 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 ga ga ma 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 ga Tivra Ma. Where night and day meet.
Yeah.
Tivra Ma rags.
Yeah, that is different from Yaman, I think.
Yaman is more night, even though it has Tivra Ma,
yeah,
it's still considered more of a night rag.
Yeah.
So these are, there will always be things refuting,
yeah,
the theories.
Yeah.
Always rags refuting the, yeah, theories.
Thank you.
Yeah. Western, of course, it has a very clear structure. I think any classical art is formalized and organized. It has its do's and don'ts. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Why do Western musicians always need their notes and Indian musicians can sing?
Because we have place for improvisation. Besides, when we sing, that will be a whole new workshop if I were to show you how we improvise. But the entire Indian classical music system is based on, you know, alaps, which we are making up on the spot. So the only part which is fixed is the four lines of the song. In their music, they are interpreting what a composer has already written. You can't tamper with that. You have to go as per what the composer has written. Quite similar to the Carnatic system. They are very, very, you know, true to what the composer has written. So if you were to compare Carnatic and Hindustani, little more improvisation in Hindustani. But in classical music, just as Bach intended it or Mozart intended it, that's how you play. But I'm sure they also have symphonies where there's a part, any of you Western musicians here, where they are allowed to improvise a little. But whatever is written by an already existing respected composer, and there are so many of them coordinating, what will happen if they start improvising? It will be complete chaos, because you have an entire bunch of instrumentalists. So how do you improvise right in the middle of that? Who improvises? Yeah, correct.
It's not jazz.
They are interpreting what the composer has written. unless they are playing jazz or which is improvisatory. Yeah.
And does every singer sing around differently? Is that
yes, absolutely, in his own style.
So which one are your favorites?
The singers, you are asking me which art? Are you asking me the favorite rags or the favorite singers?
Yeah, favorite rags with their favorite singers. Are there any particular?
Well, the classical artists I really look up to is my, of course, I have to say my guru's name, Pandit Firoz Dastur, with whom I got everything in music. I would say the essence of the Kirana style of music. Then I really look up to Prabha Atre. Dr. Prabha Atre, that's one of my favorite artists. And in Thumri, none else but Shobha Gurtu, the Thumri legend, yeah.
Madam, float, these Komal notes are flat notes, right?
Yes.
And what about Tivra, that is sharp notes?
That's sharp.
And Shudh?
Yeah, Shudh are the ones which, you know, Shudh are the ones, the natural ones. There's Shudh, there's Tivra, and there's Komal.
But in Western, like
for example, you wanted to sing them.
Yeah.
Sa re, now sa and pa never change. Sa pa, they are fixed. Sa re ga ma pa dha ni sa. These are all shuddh.
Shuddh. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Sa re, this is komal.
Komal. Re. Komal. Yeah.
Sa ga, komal ga.
Yeah.
Sa ma, yeah.
Yeah, but in the Shuddha note, if you want to talk in English, then what you call as a Shuddha note?
They say, I think notes of the, in English, they say notes of the major scale.
Major scale. Okay.
Yeah, they say and major scale.
Yeah.
So that's why I was trying to find a word myself, I couldn't find. I thought pure, natural, I just used those words.
Yeah.
What value do different gharanas add, like as far as rags are concerned?
What value do I give to gharanas?
No, what value do different gharanas add to ragas? Like, can you make out from somebody singing which gharana is from?
More or less, because we've come from the old school of singing where there were gharanas existing in our time which were very rigid. So, all of us learned the typical, you know, either we learnt Jaipur style or Kirana style or Agra. We were actually branched out and it was difficult to learn style of all the gharanas. Nowadays, everyone's trying to make their own gayaki. They are taking the good from every gharana and it's evolving now. So you may not be able to make out the gharana unless somebody is singing in the old school way. There are still some singers who haven't modified their way of singing and singing true to the way they were taught. So gharanas is a very huge topic of discussion. They have a different voice throw. They have a different area of emphasis. Some sing more tans, some do more alap. Some use akar, some use the words. So it's an entire, you know, big theory and, you know, entire discussion, area of discussion. Another Mumbai local with four different gharana artists sitting here.
Yeah, I have one question. Thanks for a very wonderful workshop.
Thank you.
There is this regarding the chalans in a rag.
Yeah.
Some chalans are forbidden. You know, I'm a student of music. Sometimes I think, wow, I mean, I use this swaras in this raga.
Yeah.
And I made up a phrase and then my teacher says, no way. This is not what you're singing.
Yeah.
So how do you decide a particular chalan, in spite of being within the raga framework, is allowed or not allowed, and on what basis, if you can enlighten?
See, chalan is the going up and coming down. If a phrase is not allowed, you can't do it.
But
okay, so now I'll give an example. Rag Bageshri. Sa ga ma dha ni sa. Sa ni dha ma ga re sa. Okay, now there is a phrase that visits ma pa dha ga, but you can't keep taking it. Sa ga ma dha ni sa ni dha ma pa dha ga ma pa, you can't wait there. And that, interestingly, since you asked that, there is a moment over there where the audience will go, ah. Why is it? Because you've taken the forbidden note. Sa ga ma dha ni sa ni dha ma pa dha ga. Ah. वहाँ आ क्यों निकलती है? बिकॉज यू हैव वेरी डेक्स्ट्रसली टेकन दैट फॉरबिडन नोट. या सो यू देर इज अ प्लेस फॉर नोट्स वे यू जस्ट स्किम बाय देम. या यस यस एग्जैक्टली सेम वे इन राग बागेशी. नाउ दिस इज अ वेरी फ्रिली फ्रेज using a lot of other notes, but it added beauty. So you better know your, be a maestro before you yeah.
So I think that brings us to the end of our wonderful session. I would like to thank Dhanashree ji very
thank you,
much.
Isha.
Thank you so much. And Ashish ji.
Ashish, of course.
The building preparation.